Hi, hello everyone. This is DHS Informatics Technologies. Today we are going to discuss about IEEE 2020 project name called Alzheimer Disease Classification using deep learning with the Gabor filter. Okay, this particular project we are developing based on the 2020 IEEE paper only. The paper title is Alzheimer's Disease Predicting Using Machine Learning Algorithms. They already built with machine learning algorithms. We are improvised that make use of the deep neural networks. Okay. In this paper, you can able to see they are using some machine learning algorithms name called SVM, random forest and all. So we are going to use a deep learning techniques. Okay. We will discuss about that about project now. Okay. We can see first domain. Okay, the domain we are choosing is a deep learning. The deep learning is nothing but it's a subset of machine learning technique only. It's maximum used in a supervised learning and semi-supervised, unsupervised, all those things we can use a deep learnings. Okay, in the deep learning we have a three major algorithms like a CNN, ANN and a RNN. Okay, in this project we are going to use a CNN algorithm. Okay, let discuss about our project further. Before that, if you are not subscribing this channel, means please subscribe, like and click the bell button. Okay, let's go to move forward. Now what are the technology we are using in this project? First one is a Python. What programming language is a Python? Then what is the software we are using? We are using Anaconda. Inside the Anaconda we have a Jupyter notebook, that is our IDE. Then we have some libraries named called Keras and OpenSV. All those things we are using in this project. Next, introduction. It is nothing but how much people affected by the Alzheimer. You can see maximum 60 to 75% peoples, they have Alzheimer problems. When aged people will come, they have ultimately that behaviors like Alzheimer behaviors they have. Okay, if you find the early stage, means we can easily solve that problem. For that only we are building this project. Okay, now next, existingly what they are using, they are using some numerical data like what is that person age and the number of visits he have, then MMSE, education make, all those things they are calculating. Based on those values they are predicting whether that patient have Alzheimer or not. For that they are using some machine learning algorithm name called SVM, decision tree algorithms, to classify the Alzheimer's and all. Okay, and next, what we are going to propose here, what we are going to propose, we are using deep neural network. Okay, deep learning. In the deep learning we are choosing convolution neural network. It is a one supervised algorithm. What is the use of it? Means it can used for classifying the images. Maximum we will used for classifying the images. Okay, in our project we are applying some of the techniques for identifying the features from the MRI images. For that purpose we are using Gabor filter. Okay, then make use of that we are building the model, and based on that we are able to achieve the accuracy highly. Okay, next, what is the procedure we are following? First we collected the MRI images, then we are using Gabor filter. Based on that Gabor filter we are extracting the feature, then we are splitting that feature into training and testing. Based on those things we are just train our model, make use of the trained model, we are test the model, then we are getting the overall accuracy. Okay, this is the system architecture which we are going to propose in this paper. Okay, next, methodology. In the simple terms I am given to here, you can able to see using Gabor filter, first we are extracting the feature, then make use of the train test split, we are splitting the data into training and testing, then make use of the CNN layer, we are building the algorithm, then make use of the train and the test model, we are achieving the high accuracy in the convolutional neural network. Okay. Okay, if you are interesting doing this project, means you without hesitation you can contact us in dhsinformatics.com. If you have any queries, means you can call us, make use of these numbers. Once again I remind you, if you are forget to subscribe this channel, please subscribe, like and click the bell button. Thank you.